Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 3, we got E, we got V, we bought the boom, bop, boom, ba, doom, ba, doom. I got smell
with
tea.
The remix though?
Yeah, I can't keep doing the same thing. I got ADD.
Okay, sure. What's up? I miss you guys.
Yeah, man, we missed a week.
I don't know what in that camera. Yeah. Sure, like a little marshmallow.
Hi y'all.
What it do, people?
Happy Wednesday.
Yay, hump day.
You'll feel good to be back. Did y'all miss being at the show or y'all enjoyed y'all little vacation?
Both.
I miss y'all.
Okay.
Whatever. You want
to. I ain't miss coming up with the lineup.
True.
But that's your job though.
I've been sitting in the lineup for the past, 2 weeks?
Yes. Yeah. You gotta have a backup.
I'm not backup. That's not what I'm doing.
At all.
I'm not doing
that. I was got leaning on you today, though.
I see.
I said, Mark be procrastinating. That shit get on my nerves. Then he wanna text me 2 hours before the show all his damn ideas.
Cause see, what happened is, I'm a last minute type of dude.
Nah,
that ain't what it is. I do everything great at the last minute.
Everybody that's following us now, let me know, what is the worst sign in regards to getting along with people? I don't get along with Aries. What about y'all? I love them, but I don't.
That was dumb. don't respond to that.
Go ahead, tell me.
I don't know. I can't say.
The worst one for me to get along with?
I don't really know everyone's sign, though. So, like, I'm not really into it. Be like, oh, my girlfriend born this day.
What's your boyfriend's sign?
Leo. But that's it.
But Aries and Leos get along.
Yeah,
we go together like the, peace and you know, curse. Shout out to
saying,
the Leos.
Like what gravitates to me, because even when we wasn't dating, that you
that
know.
Home. Yeah, me and Virgos, we could be good friends as long as there's distance in between that motherfucker. Like we can't just be cool.
We getting along.
But
anyway.
I have 5 Virgo friends.
Y'all
so.
Sneaky.
Yeah, I was gonna tell you that.
Ooh.
We get along with everybody. But everybody yeah. loves.
So how was y'all week?
Man, great. I had a good, nice little trip to Miami, my hometown.
Right. I mean, count, a boy you know. Trip, but.
Yeah, the guys were not. We always go out for my man Diddy birthday show. This was our last year going.
Why?
Because he about to turn up. He about to get older.
Oh, so he said that he ain't about that life?
No, not really. That
this is the one that got married last year, right? Yeah, the one we went on the
coordinate.
Don't play with my last turn up.
Yeah.
I mean, is he still going to go on trips?
He about to turn 50.
Oh, I could see that. Yeah.
So
Miami.
Like,
yeah, he gonna.
I mean, but what about any other place? Just not Miami.
Yeah.
Okay. But I'm still going to.
Not the last guy trip at all.
Oh, okay.
We go on trips all the time.
Okay.
Or Brazil.
That's what I need to do. I need to buy my life.
I hear like Rio. The place for dudes, like
yeah, but
dudes.
Not for married dudes.
Oh,
that's for single dudes.
So y'all have to go on a trip that's marriage appropriate.
Absolutely.
Okay, true. Well, at least y'all consider that, because some guys will be like, oh, but then maybe you don't need to go on the guy and just kick them.
I don't want no parts of that.
True.
So
what you drink?
Gatorade.
Oh,
well, how was your weekend?
Somebody got old as shit this week.
Right. I was off for a whole week, literally 7 days from work. So I started.
I
came back
maternity leave.
I came back Monday and I felt like I didn't know what was going on.
Really?
You ever just felt disheveled? Like you was just like, I don't know if I'm coming or going. That's exactly how I felt. I was in a wedding this weekend, and then y'all know
when it's
shout out to the Lattimores.
Shout out to the Lattimores.
Shout out to the Lattimores.
Congratulations.
So and then I was. In a wedding.
27 dresses like a...
No bullshit. Damn, can I get one? Can I get a white dress?
That's how I felt, though. I'm in the same boat as you.
You did?
I mean, because I had a wedding a year apart. I was in 2 weddings a year apart. But yours was literally back-to-back within weeks, so...
Okay, so Dion says... Leos, they think they know everything.
Heck,
want you to follow suit. Anitra, hi boo. Shout out to Anitra from ATL, shawty.
Yeah.
Hey, Anitra.
That's the one that got
me.
Leos do think they know everything. I will definitely say that. I agree.
Yeah, Leos, they're dominant.
Mm-hmm.
They have a dominant personality. But I think Cancers, they think they know everything too, but they're sensitive.
I love Cancers though.
You do? I do too. They're sweet.
What's that? What month is
July? What's Cancer? July, right?
Cancer like the end of June to mid July.
Okay.
So let's get this.
We about to spill this tea, all right?
You got to spill it.
Well, let's spill this tea.
Okay.
Yes. We got a lot to talk
about. We do.
Hey, we trying to get what? Three topics in, or we gonna try?
Yeah, we got a whole bunch of other stuff.
And I don't have any tea because I've been social media.
Oh, like, good. Then we can get full topics
off of social media for a minute. You know,
fast really type thing, or just
I mean, just taking reset. A break, just like needing to read and just focus and nesting and getting ready for it. I just don't have the time. It can consume you. You know what I mean?
That's what I like about Miss V.
Yeah.
V don't got no time. She don't play that bullshit. She gonna get herself together.
You
every
know how
meeting.
You just feel like you like, I need to just, you know, take it easy.
Every time I see the mic in front of Vicky's face, I think of the whole microphone situation from 2.5 years ago when we first started the show.
That was like funny.
Talking to the mic. That's what he said. Talk to the mic.
I wish we could replay that show because, like, that was classic.
That was definitely classic.
We've had, like, a couple classic shows that I wish we could, like, replay.
We got to figure that out.
Yeah, we do.
So let's get right to it. So, it was a newlywed. He basically posted this caption saying, he fell in love. He had a crush on his wife. They met like 6 years ago in class, and now he's married to her. And you could just tell he was just gushing in love, happy, but he was squeezing her butt in the picture.
The picture was sent through GroupMe, right?
No, I could show it to you though.
Okay.
But like it was the link, yeah. But he was like, it wasn't like, you know how like you gracefully put your hand on somebody's butt? No, he was.
No, it was a grope.
Yeah, he was cupping that joint.
Okay.
Needless to say, people commented, of course, bashing him, saying that he was disrespecting her and that was something intimate. He shouldn't have posted it on social media. So I was just like, I can't even believe people was offended that he was squeezing his wife's butt. Like,
so he waited.
Why
he waited 6 years to do such. First, I mean, he waited 6 years to marry her. So I think that's just the thing about social media. I don't really have no problem with it. And I think if it's your wife, then you should be able to touch whatever you want
exactly.
to. But the thing is, when you post stuff on social media, you got to know right now that this is what you're doing. You will set yourself up to be trending. You know what I'm saying? Just like that.
But I don't think he had any doubt in his mind that people would take it negative. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, how can you? I don't see how you could take something like that negative.
Mm-hmm.
Like, he wasn't choking her.
Maybe it's the assless that are a little mad because they are that.
Well, she looked like she was enjoying it.
She was fat. Yeah. Yeah. My man wife was fat. It didn't enough.
No tummy.
If y'all want to actually see the picture, you could go on Urban Intellectual site on Facebook.
Yeah, I just don't think I don't. Okay, see when you don't see your boyfriend in a long or a couple days and y'all hug and he squeeze your butt, do you get offended?
No, I absolutely don't see anything wrong with this picture. At all.
It's not really a hug if you don't squeeze the butt. Even when I hug my mother, I squeeze her butt a little bit. Like, nah, that was a joke. That was a
broom. I was about to say, it was a ding.
Yeah, bell.
No, but yeah. I really don't. I wonder if they can, like, if I show it.
Maybe,
can you zoom it in?
No, because I got the screenshot in there.
Yeah, it's not a bad picture at all. But read off some of the comments.
Yeah.
Let me see.
Yeah, that's just the internet being the extra internet at the end of the day.
Always got a comment. It's
so you could say if you freeze anything in time, you have a million thoughts about that freeze time frame, but it could be
nothing.
Mean,
that could have been just one picture out of the slew of them, you know, like that was just the candid one.
Or
they
that was the one he liked
viral.
The most. He grabbed his wife's
ass. It's his wife.
Absolutely.
And I don't think it's anything wrong with it at all.
Okay, so somebody said, one person said that's beautiful. My husband will have to wait to enjoy that in our marriage. What? Your boyfriend can't cup your ass?
Maybe she's
my listen. You ain't my girlfriend if I ain't grabbed your ass.
Somebody said worth grabbing but not posting on social media.
That's what I agree.
He should have waited to take her into a room. I mean, he was able to wait 6 years. A few more minutes won't kill him.
Oh, so what, they were celibate or something?
No, it's just they just saying they was doing too much, I guess.
I think that everything is not for social media though. We kind of pinched on it a little bit.
I think so too, but I don't think this picture is wrong for social media. I just think it's just them enjoying in a moment.
I don't really necessarily think it's wrong, but I do agree that it could easily, like, just don't even post it. It ain't even really that serious. That's your moment anyway. Yeah, that's your moment.
Somebody said, I didn't see anything wrong with it. He didn't have her slammed against the wall with his tongue down her throat.
I wouldn't see nothing wrong with that either if it's your wife, but I just think, like,
certain things shouldn't be posted.
It just shouldn't be posted.
Well, I'm not. Yeah, I agree with that.
What's the next topic?
Kudos to you, Pendergrass.
So
we, of course, we want to get into this whole rap beef thing that's been going on. Did y'all see the video of Benny Siegel getting knocked out?
Yeah. Okay, so Anthony sent this to me, or somebody sent this to me. I didn't get a chance to look at it though.
He got snuck. The first video didn't show. They just showed him being. They showed him getting hit and being knocked. No, I'm sorry. They showed him actually knocked out. But once somebody submitted a video to TMZ with a different angle, and he was standing there like talking to the people, and the dude was standing there beside him, but it looked like they was kind of almost engaged in a conversation, and then he snuck him. His back was turned, so he sucker punched him.
So I didn't see that part. I did see him on the ground. and don't get me wrong though, Beanie Siegel was like one of my all time favorite. Like, he in my top five favorite.
What's the movie? Not Paid in Full.
Damn, why you say that? State Property.
Yeah. State Property. That's
Get Down or Lay Down. He said that like 80 times, but go ahead.
Yeah, that's one of my top five rappers of all time. But when I did look a little more into it. Mm-hmm. And so the backstory to why he got stole was, it was because, I feel like this is the gossip part.
Go ahead.
But anyway, so the dudes from Philly that, you know what I'm saying, that they all was cool with, was saying that he just was doing a little treason-based shit. Like, he was reaching out to gang people, just doing a little underhanded shit, telling them stuff that was not supposed to be said. Okay. That he knew.
But why did they let him back in the circle to help with the track then?
But that's the thing. So that's another thing that they said. They was like, he came in the studio. He didn't help with the track. He just told O'Malley, which was the dude who come on first. Mm-hmm. They was basically saying, like, he just told him, like, this one you should emphasize what you're saying, as opposed to just literally sitting down.
And when did this happen? In the studio?
He got knocked out at the Bad Boy show.
I heard the Bad Boy show was like that.
I heard it too. People said it was the best concert they've ever been
Somebody
to.
Somebody said they felt like they was in a black hole though.
And that girl said she got her entire life. I heard it was a really good show. I really wanted to go.
Yeah, I was watching that from South Beach.
So I guess the topic of discussion is, do you all think rap beefs go too far? And then now with it being the social media era, like, everything, I could never see Mark writing a full-length paragraph comment on Instagram to get his point across to another nigga.
Right.
I don't get that.
Doesn't
like,
I don't get it either.
They sit here and write long, drawn. I don't even read. I can probably read the first two sentences. I'm like, I'm not reading this. Yeah. Like, what happened to just calling a dude up and asking?
Or just scrapping them.
But word on the street is that can't happen in this specific one. I think rap beef in its entirety is just totally different, because it ain't about what you saying anymore. It's about, I'm gonna make fun of you and all this old, like, this.
Taking pictures and posting it.
Man law is not real no more because of social media. Social media killed man law. So even like if this was an era, like Drake, who was definitely the most popular of the ones who had the more wittier song of the battles. I feel like if this was 96, somebody calling another man out on that, writing his raps, would have been just enough to be like, oh, that's it. Because it's like Jay-Z, like, I skied in your baby seat. Like, that's crazy. You did that? That's real life. It ain't no
Who
pixie.
You think won that? You think Jay-Z won or Nas won?
That's a good question. I'm one of the ones who really, and I ain't even
I
really
love
a big,
I think I Nas, Nas won, but go
I ain't really a big
Jay-Z biased just because he's like, I just,
yeah. Ether, he killed it. I'm sorry.
But Ether is the best song of the whole battle.
Yeah.
I will say that.
Yeah.
But you know, Nas got like three duds before that.
Yeah, he did.
H to the Omo, all them. Jay-Z was a straight. So Ether was a 10, and then Nas dropped like couple sevens. Mm-hmm. Jay-Z dropped all nines. Mm-hmm. So that's why I say he won. But I understand why the best song won in that specific. Because even in the Cannabis joint, LL Cool J just kept making songs, and Cannabis, it was like, who is he? But he won. He had the best song easily. He killed
it. What happened to Cannabis?
Nothing. That wasn't enough to withstand time. Mm. Those kind of bars.
So who? So do you think 50 Cent won the beef with Ja Rule, since Ja Rule's career kind of went down the drain after that?
It really did. It was like
it just didn't happen. And Ja Rule was hot, like he was on everybody's shit. And then it was just like, what happened to Ja Rule?
But you go through one Ja Rule was my man.
But I feel like
what I mean about? Cause that's not Ja Rule, is it?
Yeah, what would I mean about you? He called 50 called that nigga the Cookie Monster. Yeah. See, the thing about Ja Rule is the same thing that make you laugh, make you cry. Because what he did and what happens now is that everybody want to be the singer rapper now. Mm-hmm. Ja Rule kicked that door in.
Right.
And then even with 50, even after 50 made fun of him doing the shit, mm-hmm. he just came right back and did the same shit. So, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, he lost because he lost his career.
Yeah.
But I don't, you know.
But do you think the beef is what made him lose his career?
Yeah.
Do you think?
Really?
Because for real,
I just think his style, just the style of rap and hip hop changed.
Mm-hmm. I disagree because he never even got a chance to change because you didn't even listen to the joint with nobody even listened to the CD when the joint, I got 100 guns, 100 clips. Mm-hmm. That's all
I like that song.
That CD, crank. Nobody listened to that CD because he was so he already lost. It was like, all right, he is singing as. What he kept calling it? Cookie Monster. That's what he kept calling it.
So if Nicki and Lil Kim had to go head to head in battle, who would you say would win?
Lil Kim.
Hey, I'm a Lil Kim fan, right? But Nicki got bars.
She got bars. Yeah. She do.
Don't get it confused. Nicki can really, really sing.
So y'all know people been saying, like, ever since Remy Ma got back, that Nicki
she Minaj, got bars.
Nicki Minaj has no chance. Do y'all feel like between Nicki Minaj and
Remy got boss.
Who would win?
Remy. I think Nicki, I like Nicki, is so animated.
She's very animated.
But Nicki, I feel like Remy, she just got so much passion behind
and
her
she
words.
Has more of experience.
Yeah.
Like she's lived a different life than Nicki. You know, not saying like I don't know what Nicki did before. She kinda have like, you know, that street in her, like that.
I'm gonna make the hip hop fans mad.
Okay, somebody said I love Ja, but 50 got him. Dominica said 50 better than Ja, hands down. Dion said that she would say Lil Kim.
I think
Biggie
used
to write
Kim
shit.
Yeah, but by the time Notorious, Kim would prepare. Like she wouldn't come just. She gonna be
I'm a student of rap, so when they say all right, they say that big. That mean he wrote hardcore, and she got hits after hardcore. So then what?
What she have
about the Notorious K.I.M. crank, the whole CD crank.
But he was alive then, wasn't he?
Alive. He died when hardcore was running.
Okay.
So she got like 3 CDs after that. Well, she still have not the whole CD crank, but you can still hear that capability. 1, and then 2, Notorious K.I.M. crank from the beginning.
Okay, so Kim and Nicki, who you got winning?
Nicki.
You got Nicki.
I know. Listen, I know that's kind of blasphemous to like old school hip hop.
But I get it, Kim. Nicki, because
Nicki
killed
is
Monster.
Really, really like that.
She killed Monster. She killed it.
She killed a rock of Jones. Like she. First of all, the whole Lil Wayne Insane Clown Posse is full of bars. Whether y'all like it or not, everybody that came out of that little mob really could flow.
What's that? Young Money.
Young Money. Young Money got flowers.
Yeah, they do.
Okay, so what if you put Remy and Nicki together? Who would you say?
I'm going with Nicki.
Against Remy?
With Nicki over Remy?
I'm going with Lil Kim over Remy, so.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Do y'all think an artist's career died down, that there's no coming back? Or just depending on who it is?
No, because I feel like Brandy's died down and she was able to come back.
But people don't remember that Jay-Z died.
He did.
Yeah, if Carter 3 times, that nigga was gone for a brick. He came back.
I mean, because like Lil Wayne, y'all think, I think he's always going to be able to come back, but he died down.
But Lil Wayne's died down. He still make somebody a hit. Like right now, he got that joint. What's his name? That nigga out here.
Okay, they said Kim fell off.
Yeah, definitely, but I don't got her. I don't got her boss all
the time. Jeezy.
I like Jeezy, but I don't think he's ever had no rap beef. He ain't ever had a beef with nobody.
She said,
"No, I'm just saying, like, if he fell off, can you come back?"
I don't think
he fully fell off, but he don't really put out music like that.
Yeah, he got a mixtape just came out.
Yeah, I think a lot of people are doing more mixtapes, but then like Lloyd, you know, Lloyd coming back out. I used to be a huge fan of Lloyd. And then he just fell off.
But you know, like,
he was going through some stuff. What do you think about it?
Lloyd is my guy.
When I say I'm so excited he coming back out, like, I don't.
So what do you think about artists who just can't, don't make it mainstream or make it big? Like, that's how I feel about Tamir. We've had this conversation.
I like Tank. I'm sorry, I do.
He
like
be having a struggle voice when he sing live.
He be lying. He got good music though.
I think he should stick to writing. You know, he wrote Jamie Foxx, all of Jamie Foxx albums.
Now, I think it's a difference. Like, I think it's a difference between a singer and somebody that crank. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a lane for both of them. Like Ne-Yo, mm-hmm. he can't sing. He crank. Yeah. Rihanna crank.
Yeah.
Wincy crank. Like. If you crank for real, I'm gonna blow people a little bit. Okay. Because
I'm waiting for this.
This is DC, and I understand what is going on. But Marvin Gaye crank better than he can sing. Mm-hmm. You know, he's not about to wow you. He gonna stay in his little pocket, and he gonna crank. Mm-hmm. Music Soul Child crank. Those people that crank but can't really sing like that.
Yeah, I mean, then like you have some good performers that can't really sing, but they'll give you a good performance.
Absolutely.
That's how I feel about Janet.
Oh, I'm gonna tell you who else I can make you mad. Oh yeah, yeah, that's another cranker, but can't sing. I'm gonna tell you who else though. I know this is gonna piss people off. Usher.
Usher, why?
No, sir.
I think he can crank.
He cranked, but he don't sing. Name one song he killed. What? Like he was just
give it to me. I wanna give it to you.
Look where you at, right there in that little ass pocket. The little wine ass pocket. I'm gonna make this tonight. He never going nowhere.
Alright, so who can so you said
what do you think about Chris Brown then? Do you think
Chris Brown can sing though?
He need to get off that shit.
Yeah, he do.
It's messing him up.
He do. But at the same time, too, he older, too. He got, like, a real high-pitched voice. It's like going to see New Edition. Like, you're not going to get the same New Edition because they sounded like little kids.
Mm-hmm. But New Edition like that. Have you ever seen them in concert?
I have not.
They are the bomb. Beginning and end, the bomb.
So you said who I think can sing.
Somebody said Usher can sing. What the hell, Mark?
ask him what song did he kill.
I'm asked. And we got something in the group me message. Say it all depends on your street cred if you come back on that. What happened to Rudy.
Yeah, Eric, I'm taking Nicki street over cred. Kim.
I like
not in the career in the rap battle.
Them. She ain't give you one.
Yeah, because she cannot. You got some time. We got a long show. We got about
how long.
We got another half hour.
What about Jasmine Sullivan?
Can sing.
Yes, she can sing.
But what is it that she why won't she ever be on a Beyonce level? Because she don't
have to look. Well, I'm not being racist, but in order to get to a Beyonce, I had to make sure I said that with such a disclaimer.
I'm not being racist.
With my Black Lives Matter t-shirt on. But in order to make it to that next level, you have to be white people favorites.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
And
you got to be crossover.
Soul ain't white people favorite. Mm-hmm. Well, I won't say
like
that.
I was gonna say white people like soul. I think it's just the type
it's not
of
their
soul.
Favorite.
Yeah, they
don't want to hear "Bust Windows Out Your Car." That shit used to crank.
Yeah, Jasmine Sullivan is my. That's my. I love her.
Even like people like Fantasia, she would probably never be on Beyonce's level.
She don't got no hits though.
Fantasia.
I mean, not like to be compared to nobody that got hits.
Why do you think it's no R&B hit beefs? Like, R&B singers don't be beefing.
Brandy and Monica beefing. They've been beefing since the boy is mine.
Brandy just seemed like
they really thought the boy was dead. Like, shit, they still beefing
Brandy
over there.
Brandy just be seeming like she holding on to something. And Monica's like, I let it go.
I really want to know what the issue is.
I think it's overdue. I got to think.
The boy is really somebody's. That's what
exactly. Happened. Because it just seemed like they can never catch a break.
You want to know who I like, but this can't. Keisha Cole. I think Keisha Cole can sing. I just don't think
she can crank.
She got a slight struggle voice.
So we got crank versus what?
Can sing. We got crank, flat out, sing, and performance.
Crank, flat out.
Yeah. Sierra,
Ne-Yo do everything, Sierra, though. Ne-Yo entertain.
Can sing.
No, he can't sing.
Yes, he can.
Oh, my God. Hey, give me a song, please. I want y'all to give me songs if you
want. Somebody said Brandy.
Yeah, Google it. We got out.
She said Climax for Usher.
Going up. Dead. What is singing about that? Just whining, just because he up there, he ain't sing, he ain't hold no notes, it ain't over. It crank. It sound great.
Oh my goodness.
Give me another one, please, baby.
We see who can sing.
Oh yeah, definitely.
I think Neo can sing.
Time out. I can sing.
Mark, no, you
sometimes.
Can.
Like, in the shower.
I could not even in the shower. I could only sing on a scale of 1 to 10. I could only get to like a 6.899, which is great. Okay. For a nigga who sang at a 2 for the whole time. Okay. So that's all I'm saying. Anybody got a problem with that?
I disagree with the Neo comment.
You don't know who I don't think could sing.
What
I don't
saying?
Think Ashanti could sing.
Hell no.
She got singing in the shower voice.
No question.
She got better. Good songs. Like, I think it's all about the song, if it's catchy. Like, I love Rihanna. Rihanna's not a singer. She's not a singer.
But she's a performer.
She cranks.
Yeah, her songs
crank. She cranks and she is a good performer.
But yeah, she can't sing.
Beyonce can sing.
Who?
Beyonce.
Absolutely.
But I know a lot of people who disagree with that.
I don't know how you could disagree with
I'm
it.
Like,
what's the joke? What's the joke she always be crying on when she performs?
I don't know.
Is it about her daughter?
She always cry on resentment.
It's about I forgive you joint.
Resentment.
Yeah. Nah, not resentment, but she be killing that joke too. Beyonce can sing. I'm just not shopping
I'm
up.
I'm not gonna say she can't. She all right.
You know who could sing? You hands down.
You know who
my favorite?
Erykah Badu.
No, you want to know hands down?
Everybody
like I can watch it all day. Tina Turner.
Okay.
Can't fuck with Tina. They can't.
They talk about on Snap.
Erykah definitely can sing. I've heard her sing a cappella, and I was like,
Halo. Oh yeah, that was a good one. Who said that?
Who?
Halo.
Oh, that's for Beyonce.
Yeah, she hit that joint live. She look at my eyebrows. Yeah. Halo.
Now got big.
She
no.
Okay, no, I can't do it.
Sierra Marie can't sing it. Definitely can't. Yeah. I don't even know when
they
last
they
time.
She
got it.
They
she
telling
cute.
Me I'm tripping with the Neo joint. Give me a song that he
you
killed.
You are tripping with that.
Neo can.
He's a good writer.
He got a little teeny pocket that he never, ever leaves.
But what do you consider a male? Okay, who's a male, a good singer as a male that you would say?
Case?
Case is a good singer. He was a good singer. But you know what? He came out with that recent album last year, and I swear that's my favorite album.
It cranked.
Yeah, I listen to all
I'm trying to think
album.
Who else could
from
sing.
From the beginning to the end.
Luther Vandross.
Or of course, I'm trying to stay.
Private Knight can sing.
But I know I'm about to get some more
women.
He beat women. But he can sing. He can sing. Ain't nobody exposed his wife busting lips.
I just want to know if your CD good.
I think Brian McKnight can sing.
Do you think Maxwell can sing?
I think Maxwell can sing.
Maxwell can sing.
I think Trey Songz can sing.
No.
I think he can sing.
He's a cranker.
Who?
Trey Songz. I'll put him in the crank category.
I'll put him in the crank category.
Tyrese can sing.
Crank the Prince Jones.
Tyrese
can sing. He got a little range, though.
Trey Songz baby about to pop out his neck. Like, he's struggling to get that note out.
I definitely think he's in a crank session.
Tyrese can sing. I know, Keith.
Somebody
can.
Tyrese can sing. Yes, that's my baby.
Tyrese gets on my nerves, though, on social media.
But he kind of chilled out a little bit. He not as extra as he used to be.
I wonder who be making, who tells them that they're experts at certain things.
Well, who are their publicists and why are they allowing them to get
when you get, if you get 500,000 likes, then you are an expert.
People say Tyrese
these
is a
crybaby.
Yeah, he is sensitive. But we're going to take a quick break, y'all. And we be back with some more tea.
Everybody who live, we ain't going nowhere.
We be back. Go whatever.
Who coming back? We ain't even picked. V.
Oh, welcome back to Spilling the Tea. They just put me on blast. We was talking, of course, we always talk about our topics beforehand during the break. So we want to talk about, what is it, baby love?
Mm-hmm.
What was it?
Basically, like, what is your sex like? For all the mommies and daddies out there or you know, people that are pregnant now.
Or dudes who just hit pregnant females because they got the wettest booty.
It's kind of like, what is your love life like? When your significant other is pregnant and then after the baby is born, like I was asking Mark, like, does your baby sleep in the bed with you? Does mm-hmm. that, you know, hinder your sex life a little bit with your significant other, right. or whoever your child, you know, however the dynamics of your relationship is. And then when do you move the child out of the bed?
Mm-hmm. And then as a pregnant woman, do you feel sexual? Like, do you feel sexy? Like, I've talked to my pregnant friends, and they're one of my cousin, this was a long time ago, you know, she was saying during her pregnancy, she didn't feel sexy. Mm-hmm. It was just like, you know, her boyfriend would want to do it, and she would be self-conscious. Like, this big old stomach. Like
this pregnancy, I don't know. I mean, I could only speak for myself. I mean, some people I've heard say the same thing, but I felt the sexiest being pregnant. Like, I really have. I don't know. My confidence level have went to all-time high. Like, I make sure I keep myself up. I make sure I look nice. I don't know. I like rubbing my belly, like lathering it up and putting different fragrances on and stuff. I still wear cute bra and panties. Like, I don't think none of that stuff really has to change. And then I just think it depends on the person. Some people don't have a good pregnancy. Mm-hmm. Some people be sick the whole time, or some people get all these different darkness and discoloration and stuff. So, I mean, I get it. I mean, I get why sometimes your confidence level can be up and down. Then it just also depends on your partner, you know, making sure they tell their woman that they look nice or they're beautiful, or, you know, things like that. But I think it all starts with you. So, I don't know. I don't think it's any different. So I feel better.
Did your sex life change when you were expecting? If you could share, without sharing too much.
It ain't really changed. I guess
the you nervous to do it? Like, damn, I might hit the baby head or something. You know, I know that's it, but I say that, that's what people say.
Yeah, it's not at all. Like, absolutely. You know. This one day, this lady was like, "You're not that big." That's what the old lady told me. She was like, "You're not that big. This, it can't happen like that." Well, fuck it. No, for real. The old lady, that's what she told me. I don't think it changed at all. I think the positions may change a little bit. And you know, it might be a little more difficult to stay in because the pregnant.
The belly get in the way.
The pregnant vagina gets a little wetter.
Why do Mark look so stupid? What is my spot?
Because, you know.
It's like I want to answer, but I don't want to answer.
Nah, but, and then it was a three-part question. So, yeah, it all depends on the scenario. I mean, there was different phases throughout, you know, the conception of my daughter. So, you know, at some point it was cool. Mm-hmm. And then, you know. So I don't think the sex life changes at all. I guess that's mm-hmm. like you say, it's specific to the person.
To the person, yeah. Mm-hmm.
But and then when do you get the kid out of bed? Well, first of all, let me be clear. I didn't get out. I used to sleep with my mother till I was like 12 years old.
And I think I was like 10. And,
like, when I just started.
I don't know. My mom would have to clarify. Let me text her.
When I started waking up with random erections, that's when I was like, all right, it's time to go. It's time to get up out of there because this is weird. But other than that, I usually sleep with my mother all the time. That's my boo.
So you don't. Didn't rush for your baby to get out of bed with you?
Not at all. Because it wasn't you know, the sex life and baby, they don't really.
We got two comments.
So then what if you want to get it in the baby land right there?
We got two comments on our forum.
Okay, go ahead.
Someone said, when they're super pregnant, you only get the side position booty. And then somebody else said, I had to make my wife feel sexy because at that time, the look in the mirror wasn't the same. So it was my job to make her feel sexy. Mm.
The sad booty, though.
Right.
The sad booty is the best case scenario.
Yeah.
It's the sad booty with the stand up. So, like, you got, like, she got to be on the bed. You got to stand up, though. Don't be laying in with her. You stand up. Get in that motherfucker. You can just dig.
I can't. All right, go ahead. Back to the bed. Back to sleeping in the bed with the
baby. That was never really a topic for me. Mm-hmm. You know,
it's like, man, she wants to stay in the bed, she gonna stay in the bed. Right. I'm gonna train her that she has her own room and her own bed.
And then, you know,
they get clingy and cry, stuff like that.
My baby.
When my daughter was born, we didn't never live together. So mm-hmm. it wasn't really one of those, like, oh, every night we going to, you know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? When she was with me, she was in the bed with me. So mm-hmm. I never stopped it. Okay. She stopped it. And she stopped it on her own. So
maybe that's what it is. Because,
I don't know. Maybe it depends on like the living situation. Because like my boyfriend, his daughter just stopped sleeping in the bed with him. But it may be because
I don't know why. Is it different for guys when they have a daughter?
I mean, I want my daughter with me everywhere, all the time. So
I mean, in regards to sleeping in the bed.
What's the difference?
You just said like you stopped at 12 with your mother because you'll wake up with an erection.
But I don't. But she gonna wake up with it. It's,
I'm like saying you still a man.
Oh yeah, but nah, it ain't really that serious. I cuddle to the right after a while. You know what I'm saying? Just in case. Because I don't know, yes, I do still rise with the sun.
I cannot.
What you was saying, Mickey?
I was saying maybe because the whole living situation is different. So like you know because. It's a co-parent situation. Maybe that's why he preferred for her to sleep with him, and vice versa, she preferred to sleep with her dad.
Yeah, because it never really, it wasn't no reason to
cut it off.
Okay, so I know this situation, but it has also happened. Brought
tension. It was never really tension. That's a horrible word, but it was kind of like when I would come over, she didn't understand the fact that she got to get out of daddy's bed.
Right, understood.
You know, so it was kind of like a. Weaning her off the whole
sleeping. And see, with I never had to deal with that because it's very simple. It was me and my daughter time. It's me and my daughter time. So anybody else, they just like for the whole time. Like I never really had that point. And I know it's it's inevitable. But I never really introduced her to anybody that or anything like that. So it was always like this is my weekend or this is my week or whatever it is. So
okay, yeah. So I know this situation happened to someone that I know.
Mom said I was 10.
They did the co-parenting thing, and she eventually got a boyfriend, and their baby was be in the bed with her and the new boyfriend. And that became like an issue, but that issue was it was hard to get her daughter out the bed because the daughter was used to sleeping in the bed with her. So with the crying and all that other stuff, she would just fall asleep in the bed. But the boyfriend would be there. It wouldn't be like
she would be on the side with the mom.
Yeah, and but the boyfriend would be in the bed. Oh my god! And my thing is why wouldn't the baby fall asleep? You just carry her in her room or put her in her own bed.
She probably not waking up and coming back anyways.
I think that it's a little. I can understand why the father would be bothered by that.
Yeah, that is that. This is the type of shit where I got gray hair now. Just the thought of that type of shit, oh my god, I can't think about it. Like that is crazy. Like my baby in the bed with because for real, he gonna try.
What you mean?
I mean,
oh, he gonna try to get some.
So absolutely. Okay, so what is the difference? Okay, so somebody said. Their son sleeping in bed with their grandmother and her boyfriend. What's the difference? Like, so is it just because?
Oh, so the grandmother watches the baby, her grandson.
She got a boyfriend. So is there a difference, or is it just because it's your girlfriend, your baby's mom, and her boyfriend? So should it? You know what I mean?
I don't know if it's a difference. I don't.
Like, would you not want her sleeping in the bed with nobody and their boyfriend? But
you,
period.
Personally, I would prefer if my mom was still here, God rest her soul. I would prefer it just be my kid and my mom. And if my mom had a boyfriend, I would prefer that my child not sleep in the bed with all three, with both of them. Yeah, that's just me. And in the same situation, if I had a kid by a dude and he got a new girlfriend, I wouldn't want my baby in the bed with. The both of them.
And just to be clear, a lot of like for instance, people who kill people always think they're gonna get killed. So
what? Get the engine running. Go ahead.
Absolutely.
Okay. Drive it home.
So I would hate for.
You look like David Bannon is right now for some reason, but go ahead.
I would hate for somebody to be like me and my young self with my daughter to be, because it didn't really matter. It was not my kid.
So you've been in the situation.
I'm just saying my young self didn't care that much. I'm not saying I've been.
Okay, so your young self, your young self wouldn't care if the girl had her baby in the bed. You was going to try. You was going to slide in.
Especially if she was like 1 to 3. Like, you know what was going on. Go back to sleep. Take your head back to bed. We doing stuff. So yeah, I just wouldn't want that to. You know what I'm saying? Like, I wouldn't want nobody who doesn't have a developed mindset to even have that opportunity to not give a shit.
Agree.
Yeah.
But that's not saying that's what I did.
I mean, I don't know. I agree with both of y'all. Like, I mean, I think it's a, you know.
You know, I'm a negative.
No kids in the bed.
Especially if it's, I don't know. You just be hearing all these stories on the news. These dudes be pedophiles.
It's so much.
I would just be nervous. Like, I just would not be comfortable.
A dude could be hitting you and playing in your daughter head.
Precious. That's what happened on Precious.
Mm-hmm. I never seen Precious.
It was a sad ass movie.
Yeah, I heard that. That's why I never watched.
Yeah, but it's just like, you know, and in the movie, she asked him, like, well, what did you do? And she was like, I let him do it. Like, I let mm-hmm. But she was fucked up in the head anyway. But it's just, you hear so many stories about things that happen. And then with these guys, when they do stuff to kids, when the mother, I'm not leaving my 6-month-old baby with a dude I just met. I don't understand why women do that.
I don't know about that, though.
What?
You would not leave your 6-month-old daughter with a girl you just met.
I can't.
If the baby's 6 months, how long have y'all actually been? And the baby ain't yours.
Right. Yeah.
And you'd be can you watch him while I go to work? And then you come back and your baby, I'm about to go to work.
Yeah, I mean, 8 hours, that's a little weird. But at the same time, I don't feel, because that was brought up in the same context as sleeping with her, I don't feel the same about both of those. Like, I definitely feel like laying in a bed with your girl and somebody else's kid.
What about your daughter sitting on another guy's lap?
That doesn't really bother.
That don't bother you?
I mean, not like that. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
so what's, like, the underlying, like, hell to the no, the sleeping thing?
Sleeping thing is a hell to the no. Sitting on the lap is uncomfortable to an extent, though, because I guess I'm a little optimistic in thinking that majority of men aren't just perverts. Like, like, I know a lot of great guys.
Yeah.
And, like, we all grab each other's daughters. Right. And it's never, like, that would never even, so it will never cross anybody's mind that, oh, man, he's getting a cheap feel off on that. So I like to think that the vast majority of the world operates like that, even though I know that there are creeps out there.
Right.
So that's not really one of those, like, nah.
What about, like, showering your child and stuff? Like,
dead. That's a dead mission. Fuck that. Pow, pow, pow.
Are you comfortable washing your daughter when she was little?
I never was uncomfortable. My daughter got uncomfortable with me before I got uncomfortable with her.
Really?
Yeah, like now, like if I could come in and be like, I gotta be like, stink, I'm not looking. I'm about to get some tissue. Like, she be like, daddy, you don't even got nothing. Like, what are you doing?
Back to the, you would feel uncomfortable if somebody else washed just like if your child's
I don't like the visual right now. Yeah, I don't know how I feel in the growth stage of that thought process, but since you brought it upon my mind right now and it is so fresh, I'm gonna say hell to the fuck ass no. Like, that's just, I don't know about that.
I'm laughing at my sister. She crazy.
My niece's boyfriend, you know, when Ashley was born, he wasn't really comfortable with changing, like wiping her, stuff like that. He would be like, yes, you could do that. And I think he's comfortable now, but I think beginning he was a little uncomfortable with thoroughly wiping her vagina area and things like that.
So this what made me comfortable. If you don't do it right, she gonna get a rash. I was like, shit, fuck that. Split. It's good. It's clean. There's no rashes. That's all. Because rash equal pain. I ain't want my baby to be in pain. I ain't want her little shit to be broke out. I just split. White.
And get it together.
Do that joint in the. I was that joint. Buckets. I grew up like my family. Growing up, my family was real, real tight. So like all my little cousins, all of them, I call all of my nieces and nephews. So I had a part in all of them. So by the time my daughter got here, it wasn't really weird.
Okay, I got a comment. They said, I was teaching my stepson how to bathe properly when we were both in the shower and his mom was in the room. Then he said,
oh, wait, hold up. It's a guy.
He was in a shower. What is
bigger than mine? No more showers together ever. Laughing like,
shit. Wait, he took a shower with his stepson.
Yeah.
How old was the stepson?
I don't know. I don't know that you got to take a shower to bathe properly. But I understand it, but I just don't know the definition.
Okay. We got got a comment. If my son is in the bed with her and her dude, she dead.
Wow. Stop. I ain't want to say that because I don't, just in case I have another kid, I got a baby in the bed. I don't want him to know who killed whoever, but I agree. You know what?
He crazy. I don't know. I feel like, I don't know. I'm a little biased. I don't know. I think I just sip my tea on this conversation. We'll talk after the show go off.
I think it just depends. I don't know on the situation. I think that
I definitely understand all of y'all's points of view.
I think the sex of the child is a factor as well. I don't think your little girl, your daughter, should be in the bed with her mommy and her boyfriend.
But because it's still also a such thing as energy too. It's a so even like you still like gotta be protective. Like I feel like as a parent, your number one job is to protect the innocence of your child for as long as you can. Mm-hmm. So that when they finally understand things, they understand it. Because they wasn't rushed into it. Like I said on the last show when I was here.
Let's be clear.
No, but like I said on the last show, like I still ride that fence where I don't really understand, you know, what's preserving innocence and what's are you ready for this? You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, I feel like that's your number one goal is to make sure that you preserve the innocence, because innocence is love, innocence is life. Mm-hmm. And when you start getting tainted, when your vision start getting tainted, that's when you easily become a fool to the illusion of what's not so innocent. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm.
So. Agreed. Don't we what's have the next topic?
What did you send? You sent that long thing about
she tried.
I gotta find it.
No limit. I got a couple. Somebody said Kim Cassane. Kim for male singers.
Oh, yeah. No, Anthony Hamilton. We forgot about him.
Anthony Hamilton, John Legend. Kim. I don't know why they go hand in hand.
Yeah, all of those.
I can't let John Legend. I feel like he can only sing certain kind of songs. You know how Jennifer Hudson can only sing certain.
Maybe because that's just what he likes.
So I think he got a raspy voice, but he got range with the rasp. He does have range. He could go from here to there.
And then you got to understand that I feel like with him, he can do...
R. Kelly could sing. He a pedophile, but he could sing.
Yeah, he could sing. But you know, like a John Legend is on a couple hooks for hip-hop artists.
Yeah.
And it flows, you know, like, I don't know. I like him.
Who got the best hooks? I could think of like six dudes who might could just be in the top five for best hooks.
Okay. Oh, the Lloyd, next topic was Charles
Akon.
Support.
Okay, let's do that. Lloyd, Akon, T-Pain. Trey Songz, Chris
T-Pain
Brown.
T-Pain with the auto-tunes?
Like, T-Pain is...
Jennifer Hudson, though.
T-Pain is an artist.
That's
what irritates
me. It's too strong.
She do the same thing every time.
She scream about
like,
it.
Oh, here she goes. She's about to do the church here. I'll be like, come on.
And I don't know who's Jacquez.
I don't know Jacquez.
That must be that generation.
Yeah, that's my cousin. Your cousin cannot do it. We don't know him.
No, so the child support thing, question topic was child support. Do you think it's a good system, and what should be changed, and should more women be placed on it?
Yes.
I definitely don't think it's a good system.
Horrible system.
Yeah, it's a horrible system. I was just on Facebook yesterday, and this guy that I went to school with, he posted like, he's always with his daughters. He constantly posts his pictures with them. He adores his children. And I guess he's going through a custody issue with his kid's mom. And he posted that now he has to pay child support. And he was like, I don't understand the system. I do everything for my kids. She pretty much manipulated the system to get it. And he was saying, you know, people probably get mad at him for posting it, but he's frustrated. Did you see it?
But I take it that means it's somebody we both know.
Yes, I'll pull it up.
I'm sure he
don't mind sharing it, because he's actually put out a GoFundMe page to help with his legal fees. His name is Kurt Little. Check him out, y'all. I mean, I felt reading it, I was heartbroken for him, because I haven't actually had a conversation with him since Mark had his brunch thing with like last year or whatever, and he came from Florida. But he adores his girls. And absolutely. Clearly, evident that she's doing this to be malicious.
Yeah, that's another reason why
What's so fucked up about the whole situation in regards to child support is that you would think these judges would see through that bullshit, and they just don't.
And that's the part that I don't like, because I think that...
That's all.
But because we already can see, like, it's very clear that this day and age that the court system is not on our team. Mm-mm. It's definitely
unless you live in Georgia. Go ahead.
It ain't on your team no matter where the hell you live.
Georgia, the dudes down there, they get their kids. Ludacris got his.
But that's his child support. But they still going to jail by the shitload for
insurmountable. They got custody.
Right, but I'm just talking about in general that the court ain't on your side. It's definitely obvious that in this specific situation, it's a real life war out here on black men. Mm-hmm. And so that's another way to get your black ass. If you work hard and you got CDL or if you got a, you know, any kind of license, first thing they're gonna do is they're gonna take it, mm-hmm. right?
And it's like, how you gonna work?
Right.
How you gonna pay the transport?
Then they gonna send you to jail.
Yep.
So it's a real life war, and then it's just based on somebody else's word versus mine. Mm-hmm. The problem I really have with it is that I don't like the fact that such emotional creatures, and I know y'all be getting mad at me when I attack y'all emotions, right? But such emotional creatures get so much power. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So when you at your maddest point, you get the power to kick me in the nuts without me even being able to do nothing to you. And that's just not fair for anything.
That and to take your kids keep your kids from seeing you. You know, that's the first thing women do.
That's the proverbial kick in the nuts.
And then it's the taking you to court for child support threats. You know,
this because they are emotionally unstable.
Absolutely.
And they do this because they are bitter. Mm-hmm. And they do this because, and they don't care about the child at all. Now, don't get me wrong. I think child support is needed when the father is not doing mm-hmm. what he is supposed to do. Absolutely. As a parent. When you do it to be malicious and you do it to get back and then you keep taking him back for increases and shit like that, mm-hmm. and you driving a Benz and he barely making it, right. Like, come on. And then especially when they have other kids that they need to take care of, you don't give a fuck about them other kids. Mm-hmm. All you want to do is make sure your kid, and half the time the money don't even go towards the kid.
And that's a community killer. And that's a very great point, though. A lot of times we can't even trace this. I seen this one, like if we was just being fair, right? Mm-hmm. Then when we go to court and they say, all right, I award her $500 because of, let's say, child care. Instead of me giving her $500, we should have $200 or $300 child care voucher that we get, right? Mm-hmm. And then we should have a clothing voucher that we give it, mm-hmm. right? Because if we just really being fair, then that really is no incentive for a woman to be so petty when mm-hmm. she don't get nothing out of it. Like
this is the thing that I say. Okay, boom. Typically, when men are put on child support, the child house, they also have to pay for their health insurance, right? Mm-hmm. Which means you got to go from single to family, which, mm-hmm. of course, in some cases can double an amount, right? Yeah. Then you got to sit here and dish out $1,400 a month. My thing is this. Why isn't whatever you dish out, she dishes out equal to that?
Mm-hmm. Right.
You telling me, oh, I need $500 for clothes, if that's the case. Well, where your $500 at?
Mm-hmm. And I do agree with this because I think this way about everything. I think this way about marriage. I think this way about anything. I feel like if me and you... if we have to come together with one idea, if I just so happen to be in a better position than you are, mm-hmm. then there's a way mathematically for us to be equal based on our position. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So that's one thing that the child support system tries to do, mm-hmm. is they say if you make 70 and you make 50, well, then it's every 75 cents to your dollar, mm-hmm. type of thing. And I don't know if that's how it really works.
Right.
Because I haven't been on it, and that's a beautiful blessing. Mm-hmm. Right. But that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? That makes sense to the extent that if you just in a better position and you have more to give to your mm-hmm. situation. But I just don't, systematically, we shouldn't depend on anything. And that's one thing. And that kind of like going to the presidential debate. They're going to Black Lives Matter. They're going to all of this shit. They're going to the police killing. What people have to do is become a fucking adult and mm-hmm. govern yourself. That means when you do fucked up shit, you look at your own self in the mirror. Don't wait for no law to pass. It's so many times that I talk to like fake people who fake understand, and they be like, well, the law says if she over 18, I can hit. or some stupid shit. That's not governing yourself. Mm-hmm. That's not being a grown up, because you know you way older than that. Right. So why would you even play those games? When you start governing yourself, your community go, people grow. If a woman say, I'm mad that this nigga cheated on me, mm-hmm. but his daughter adore him or his mm-hmm. son adore him.
Don't he think get like her. That.
Yeah, but I'm saying.
If him want to be with me, but or he with that bitch now, so I'm going to make him fuck pay. Her.
They taking pictures in.
That's my motherfucking child.
She got money. He got money.
Yeah, that's my child. Yeah, absolutely. And I tell her I'm the mother. And
yeah. Absolutely.
They know who their mother is.
And then, but guess what? As far as governing yourself, that go for men too, because there's some men out here that ain't shit.
Yeah.
That deserve to get their dumb ass locked up because they ain't paying child support. Exactly. So I ain't saying that it's not just a one-sided thing.
I think it's fucked up. The system is fucked up when people take advantage of it. And when they do, I'm for certain that these judges know that this woman is doing this to be spiteful, especially if a man you coming in, and I hate when a man act like he don't know his rights. Mm-hmm. Like, come on, you got just as much rights.
Some of them don't.
They don't want to fight for it. They always but they listen, use the street.
But sometimes I think they get a little frustrated as well because they think they go through these matters of going to the court system and doing everything the right way and constantly get turned around or leave out of court feeling defeated.
You don't understand how it feels to have someone snatch your child away. Like if you was walking holding your child and somebody tried to snatch your child, you would beat them to death. Mm-hmm. You don't know how I feel for somebody to snatch your child. There's and it's not shit you could do about it. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure that's how slaves felt. Mm-hmm. Like no matter how much I know I knock your ass out, I really can't do nothing, because then I'm really gonna be irrelevant, because mm-hmm. I'm gonna be locked up. Or I'm not even going to be able to
really
see it at all.
Taken away from
absolutely. Mm-hmm. So it's
like you got to play the part. You got to go in there, smile, show face. When really you can't stay in their ass. You know, like you frustrated.
Well, that's
you
why it's important when you have. I can appreciate judges that are fair and they know mm-hmm. they can smell the bullshit a mile away.
Right.
Especially the ones that come in here try to get all these increases and they don't do this. And when you pull out those receipts.
Or they get child support and they still want you to go in half for braces, go in half for the football,
absolutely.
Athletics, that he need this. And I'm like, what you using
that'll be the same person that tell that baby that your father didn't or your mother didn't. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, nah, you can't play football because
your father ain't giving me the money towards this.
He done already dropped
$100 a month.
Exactly.
That's crazy.
And you looking cute. What the
styling.
Yeah, but it's like I said, man, I think it has to be a collective idea to rebuttal the system. Mm-hmm. And the only way that you rebuttal a system is if you are your own government. You know what I'm saying? Hey, we stuck on the website too, babe. But that's the only thing. Like, you gotta that's what our problem is. And I think a lot of it is what we talked about earlier, like social media and music. How both of them play a part into us being afraid to govern ourselves. You know what I'm saying? Like, these rappers ain't out here rapping about responsibilities. These singers ain't using their voice to sing about responsibility. They singing about, but they try to show you how to get to the box. That's all. I mean, if we could think of the last top 10 hits, it ain't going to be about nothing about responsibility.
No, not at all.
You know
it's
what I'm saying?
It's about spending money here.
Wasting it.
Going to the strip club.
Yeah.
Buying this car.
Yeah.
Pushing this dope.
Yeah.
Doing this for this girl.
Yeah. And you just might drop a Black Lives Matter bar every once in a while. Yeah. 20,
or like Rick Ross, he
cities.
Might drop a franchise. Checkers and what else he got? Wingstop. He might throw that in there. Every hand there. You know,
just to get that black dollar generating all this business. That's the same shit Jewish people do. So that ain't really, you get no passes for that. But it's just, like I say, that's my favorite line. Because when I wake up, that's what I think about. Like, what are you doing to make sure that you governing what you supposed to do? You know what I'm saying? That's what we got to do.
Somebody say popping Xanax.
Yeah, popping Xanax,
drinking
sipping
dirty
perk,
Sprite.
Doing all the shit that really remove your conscience. That's what rappers want you to do. That's why every rapper, it seems like every rapper high now. Every last one of them. They want you to remove your conscience, what's already dwelling inside of you. Mm-hmm. Like I always say, common sense is the best conscience. So if you know that if you do drugs, it's going to kill your brain cells, it's common sense, and stay woke.
I don't think people think that their body's going to respond to that. I think people try to say, oh, I'm going to try and see what happens. Yeah, I'm thinking they'll get addicted.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you're going to. Absolutely. You're going to get addicted to anything that feels great.
And you're going to be chasing that first high.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, absolutely.
Janet Jackson
is really like pregnant.
Yeah, she's really good. But thank you guys so much for tuning in. We appreciate you. Make sure you follow us on all of our social media handlers, spillingthetea.a on Instagram, Spill the Tea Show on Twitter, Spill the Tea Radio Show on Facebook. Mark, what's going on? You got a party coming up.
Oh, easily. So we got a party coming up in Georgetown. Very grown and sexy party. That's why I wore my grown and sexy glasses today. I feel like Malcolm
Little.
I think I'm Malcolm Little.
All you need is the red hair.
Nah, but really. So I got a party coming up. Malmazing. It's
What is it?
That is Malmazing. Yeah. That is in Georgetown. Very sexy. I don't know if you missed the first one, but you could just have
parties going on. You know, I'm bumping.
I know.
Summer 16.
But you're doing a great but you're doing a great thing. That's a creation of life, man. It ain't nothing better than you. That. But yeah, so we got The Fix, newly added. We got We Are 7. And guess what? We bringing Wincy back. If you ain't see it, just follow the hashtag Every's Experience, man. There was a lot of great everything. It was a lot of fun, food. It was one of the probably the best parties I ever threw. That's why it was so nice I did it twice. So we brought that back, and I keep y'all posted. Oh, yeah, happy birthday to the homie Chaz, too.
Happy birthday, Chaz.
Happy birthday, Chaz. See you guys next Wednesday.
All right, bye, y'all. Out.